It's the Wrestlingus Show, and I am your host, Pretty Boy Cav Manning.
And I'm Fausty Walnuts.
This is Season 2.
L9.
And this is everything that's going down in pro wrestling. Time for your TNA
Impact
report. Bobby Roode gets his first win
in the Bound for Glory series.
And he goes and takes a page out of his old book, the way he won his world title the first shot, by using a bottle of beer on James Storm. This time he uses a bottle of champagne, because we know the ring crew likes to drink champagne after they've deconstructed a ring, because they're celebrating over there. So this time, of course, there is glass all over the ring. And like last year, or not last year, but when he won the title, the ref didn't even notice the glass all over the ring. He dives into a pool of glass and makes a count. This time,
he had shards of glass in his hand as he was counting.
This time the ref sees all the glass, wonders what it is, brushes it aside, and makes the three count. So in about 5 years from now, we will, you know, gradually grow and evolve to where they don't make the three count after they see glass in the ring.
Hey, baby steps. The last couple of weeks we saw Manic in the back talking to the camera. We saw his face. They even acknowledged the name TJ Perkins and whatnot. This week, we see him in the back, but from behind as he's talking to Saban. But they're hiding his face now all of a sudden. Like, all of a sudden, his face is a mystery. Like, they changed their mind.
This whole Manic angle is giving me Manic depression.
Taz has been gone from TV for a couple weeks, but now he's back, but he's barred from the building. Didn't Aces and Eights win full access, like, months ago on a pay-per-view? Anyways, we see him out back, what, just so he can open up the limo door to find an old 1990s laptop?
Dude, you're getting Adele.
So after we see Adele,
and not the fat pig from Europe,
and on the screen we get another promo for the August 1 warning.
You know, the buoyest part about this whole thing was not that, not the August warning inside the limo, and that's why Taz is out. Taz is complaining about the heat while wearing a leather vest. Come on now.
So we got the big reveal. August 1 warning is UFC legend Tito Ortiz. First we got Rampage, now we got Tito Ortiz. Dude, are you excited? Hey, we did this bit already, let's go.
But my nut rag. So you can tell from my reaction and Mr. Anderson's reaction that nobody really cares. There's great acting in the ring too by this. If you can go back and watch on YouTube, you want to see the acting of all these caliber actors in the ring.
They just kind of all stood around and
scratched their head like they didn't know what was going on, which is pretty much what the wrestling world was like. We don't know what the hell's going on. I mean, come on, this is just bad. They keep hiring more UFC, MMA guys, whatever the hell you want to call it.
And on a serious note, Kurt Angle was arrested again for a DWI and has checked himself into rehab.
Now we see why he wears these sunglasses all the time.
Oh, those patriotic ones?
Yeah, but the problem is his eyes are very patriotic now. If you look very close, they are blue, white, and red.
Hey, let's talk some World Wrestling Entertainment.
Let's! Actually, something happened on SmackDown. Vicky, all of a sudden, I can't believe what I'm seeing. Is she a face?
An ugly one.
Hey! Actually, a great match on SmackDown, a three-way between Christian, RVD, and Orton. Absolutely fabulous match. Could be one of the matches of the year. And I'll tell you, RVD getting stuck in the mat with that RKO. I mean, he went head first. His neck has to be killing him. He gets fucking drilled.
Hey, when you're high as shit like RVD is, you don't feel a thing. Hey, let's welcome back Ricardo Rodriguez back from his severe injury. And what happens?
Hey man, you see what happened to Ricardo Rodriguez?
Yeah, man.
A loyal Ricardo Rodriguez. He comes out there, you know, does his job, introduces correctly, dressed to the nines.
13s even.
Always proper. Beautiful introduction. Mm-hmm. Spit bucket. A man to hold another man's spit bucket is hard to find.
That's a true friend.
That is a friend. He comes out there, helps him over the years, always putting his life on the line. You know, in trouble and hard times, always there for his man, Del Rio. And what happened? He made one mistake. Sure, he made a mistake. He put the bucket there.
We all make mistakes.
We all do. Nobody's perfect.
Nope.
You know, Mr. Perfect came close. Mm-hmm. But as we learned in his matches, he wasn't perfect as well.
Right.
I remember from an interview where Bruce Beefcake told everybody, nobody's perfect. And they should take a wise lesson from this. Carter makes a simple mistake. He apologized in the ring. Apologizing. And what happened? Del Rio kicks him right in the head. Man, that Del Rio, he burned me up. He had a good friend. A friend is hard to have. That's why I value you as a friend.
I would never kick you in the head.
Thank you. I appreciate that very much, but Del Rio needs to learn a lesson. So hopefully when Ricardo comes back from this, 110%,
yes,
he will be on the side of good to defeat evil.
Because good always prevails over evil.
You tell him, brother. Being fucking Mark's rules.
Yeah, it does. Yeah! Total Divas this week, which, by the way, had more viewers than TNA Impact. Just a side note. Now, a lot of people are wondering, is it all K5? Or is it a shoot? Or is it in between?
And I'll tell you, my new girlfriend on there, that Eva Marie, she is shady. Oh my boy, I trained ballroom, I trained fucking ballerina.
Oh fuck.
Okay, she goes right to the camera afterwards, fucking in the back. Fuck, never danced in my life. Fucking, she goes out. I have never seen that all go out to watch, dude.
Yeah.
Dressed to the 13s, goes out there, fucking, not even a fucking step walk when she comes out. She fucking goes out there, fucking, hands in her hair.
Did they run it once and they said, let's do it again? And Fandango's like, no.
No, he left. No. Like, oh, would you like to dance with? Fucking out. Goodbye. Absolutely horrible. But I'm like, she didn't even, I think she would do the fucking, you could bullshit your way. What?
Yeah.
I'm going to do how Summer, or Summer does it too. I'm going to show you how Eva should come out. Yeah, fucking, if you will, some Fandango music.
Ba-da.
That's it. That's all you gotta do. You fake it. Listen, I could paint Jackson Pollock's too if nobody believes it. I could do it all.
Did you see that lump Cena had on his elbow?
You know, the scoop is that he's actually trying out for the sequel to Popeye, believe it or not. Cut it out. Oh! It's that time again. You can hear the music.
You know, so well, Jose, like, making the times and everything. See, they're starting the shows and everything.
They're starting.
Fucking, it's been a while since you've been here when we flipped around. Me Twitch was at the end. We're about done with this. And how the fuck do you get in here anyway? The door's the opposite way.
They don't call me the cats for nothing, homie. I climbed up 5 floors to get over terrorists and everything, you know what I'm saying?
Fucking Christ.
So let me do it, man. I give a Mexican a chance. You know, like, did that one time. I can do it. I can do it.
Does it sound like a fucking Mexican show to you? I don't think it fucking does. You think you can fucking handle this?
No problems, homie, no problems. If I can handle shit out there, I can handle the meat twitch.
And you know what to do, you know, cap off?
No,
that's very important.
Cap off and everything, see? Just cap off and everything. You know, Joel's playing in the background and everything.
I'm fucking Billy Idol. Close enough.
Come on, homie, you let me do it?
Alright, fuck it, we take the rest of the show off. You wanna fucking do it?
No problem.
Fucking meat twitch your boards across the way? Fucking have at it. We'll see what you can fucking do.
I got it. Just keep my music. By the way, you look like an asshole with that hair, dude.
He's gonna call me an asshole after he fucking gets the gig, right?
Fresh cap on my golf size 8 fitted. Wasn't born with a silver spoon, I ate with it. Never cheat death, we all have a date with it. But keep a gat in my drawers and I'm straight with it. I keep it moving steady, so I'm never situated. Sidestepping on.
Alright, so there you have it. This week's Meet Twitcher winners is Summer Rae. And you know what? I'm thinking maybe we change it to the Cat's Corner. No more Meet Twitcher. And then pound the Cat's Rukas. You know what I'm saying? This Ruka right here reminded me of a Ruka. I have to go back and dance the pink poodles, man. Oh, shit, it's a fat ass knife. It's sprinkling down. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I just always wanted to know, too, because your hair was so blonde. I wanted to see if the hair on top matches the hardwood floors and my pillows. You know, because the cat has a lot of moves in this freaking litter box over there on top of the hills. You know what I'm saying? Looking over San Jose, you know, because the world is mine, baby. But, you know, I had to get rid of that hyena because, you know what I'm saying? She gave me, for Christmas one day, you know what I mean? She gave me an Xbox game. And I'm thinking, well, look, who has an Xbox? I got Dreamcast, you know what I'm saying? I mean, the graphics on that.
Hey, Jesus fucking Christ. Always. Fucking busy.
What?
Fucking trying to give a Mexican a chance. He can't even get through the fucking segment. Talk about his Rukas, for God's sake. So.
Where were we?
Anyway, that's your winner of the week, Summer Rae, at Pound Meat Twitcher, of course. She was looking good. She beat out a tough week with the Bellas and AJ and Caitlyn.
Nikki Bella, yeah.
Not the other one changed her name to Flapjacks McGee, but I heard that was a rumor.
No TNA action this week because we had Gil Kim and ODB.
Yeah, that seemed to be.
And
so,
as we well know.
Yeah, Pigville, population 1. So if you will, let's get this right. Cap off. Alright. We get Summer with her 2 spot. She moves from the 1. She has her own part now. Summer Rae. looking beautiful. I like she had to pull down her little dress to, you know, so there was no lip slip.
Hiding that hardwood floor down there.
Exactly. So, remember, always check out the Meat Twitcher. You got to do at Meat Twitcher. And also check out Zazzle.com/Wrestlingus if you want some cool shirts like we got.
Like cool kids.
Yeah, be the cool kids like us. So remember, when things are tough, things are down, it's rough, remember, together, we're assholes!
That Uruka has some fat ass noggins.